Welcome back to the Python tutorial. So in this video tutorial, I'm going to explain you the Python file handling. So in this whole tutorial, we are understanding what is Python file handling and how to use the Python file handling and how to open the file and how to read and write the content of the file and how to close the file. So this is the very important topic. So I will explain you what is file handling. Till now, like, we have learned some of the concept. Now we are learning here is the file handling. Means like file handling is an important part of the any web applications. Like in Python, we have several functions for creating, reading, updating, and deleting files. So here in file handling, the key function for working with file in Python is open functions. So open is the functions in Python. So by using open functions, we can perform the open the file name or open the file name or over like so normally open is the functions. So it takes the two parameter, that is file name and mode. Like file name example, I will give file name will be xyz.txt. This is the file name. And the mode in the sense like whether it is a read mode or whether it's a write mode or whether it is a append mode. So this is called as a mode. And there are the four different modes in the methods for our modes for opening a file in Python. So now I am going to explain what are the different modes for opening the file in Python. So there are read mode, append mode, write mode, and create mode. So now I will explain you what is read mode. So how to represent the read mode. So read mode is represented with the R symbol, that is small r. So default, if you are not using any mode, so that will be default considering as the read mode only. And this read mode opens file for reading. And if file does not give, it gives the error if file does not exist. So in read mode, it gives the error if the file does not exist. So it will won't create the file. And next one is the A, that is append mode. So append opens the file for appending the file, appending the content, or it creates the file if does not exist. See, the difference between the read and append is if file exists, it will open the file or it will not create the file name when we are using read mode. When we are using append mode, opens the file for appending, and if the file doesn't exist, it will create the file. And next one is the write mode. So write mode opens the file for writing purpose. So it creates the file if does not exist. So this is normally to write any content to the file. So we are using the write mode. Next one is the X, that is create mode. So creates mode used to specified file, like it returns an error if the file is not exist. So these are the two modes. And in addition to this, we can specify if the file should not be handled in binary or text mode. So we have the two modes, like that is the /t, just we can use this t, that is a text default value text mode. This is text mode. And we can use the b, that is for binary. So this is a binary mode. It's like a binary mode, for example the images and all. Now so I will going to explain you the syntax of file opening, how to open the file and what is the syntax of that opening the file. So to open file, we have the functions called open. So as I already explained, there is a function called open, and it will takes the file name, that is which file we want to open the open. And next is the mode, in which mode we want to open the file or perform the any operations like read operation, write operation, append operation. So these are the modes. So we want to perform the operations on the file. So now I will show how is the syntax for file openings. Here I will write on the exam in node sections, I will write the syntax. So I will take f as a variable and open is the keyword here, open, and you can pass the file name here. Example, demo dot text. This is the my file name. So this is the basic syntax for opening the file. And if you are not specifying here any mode, it will be by default considered as a read mode. If you want to specify the mode, so you can specify here by using read mode, or we can write mode, or I can append mode, or I can create mode. These are the four modes so we can use in file handling. So if you are not specifying anything here, the default will be considered as a read mode only. And next I'm opening on the file, and so I will give an example how to read the file content. And now I will going to demonstrate how to read the file using open functions and with read functions. So to read the, we have the functions called read. So I'm going to explain that one also. First we'll understand what is read operation here. So in Python we have the open for the opening the files, and it function return the file objects. Like I'll show, it returns only the file object, not returns the content of the file. Like I'll take one example, file f is equal to open, and I mention the file name here. That is, so I'm considering this is my notes is the text file. So I will take this file and I'll demonstrate the notes.txt. So if I not mention any modes here, by default it will be taking as a read mode. So now I will print the file, that is f. So now I will get the reference or object of the file, not the content of the file. So this is, see, we can see this is the my file. This is the by default mode will be taking read mode. So this is the example. And now I will take I want now next step I want to read the content of this file. So see, these are the my file content, so I want to read these contents. So for that we have the read method here. So by using read method we can read the content of the files. So it read is the opening parenthesis and closing parenthesis. This is the read method. So now I will show how to use the read method with this. This only prints the file object, that is this one. Now I will going to print file content, that is f dot, there is a form method called read. So you can notice here this is the read. Now I will going to run this program. So now you can observe here my all file contents will be displaying. This is the method to read the content of the file. So this example shows the file opening and file reading. So by default I am reading in read mode. So now if I want to change, you can change, or else you can leave. By default it will be considering a read mode only. So this is one I'm reading in the read mode only. So I mentioned the read mode, but there is no changes in the, like as it is, I will be getting the output only. So this is the example of read mode, that is reading the file with read of method. And like if the file is located in different locations, so we'll have to specify the full path. Like example, so I will give one example. So if this text file is present in the, I'm working in this project directory, that is user Ramesh Pujari and project PyCharm project Django project. So in this file only it will project, it will, this file is present, that is notes dot text file is present. So that's why it's working. If the file is not present in this directory, means we have to give the full path of the file. So then only it will work. Example, like example, we have to give the this full, like which drive is it, is there, or like example, I'll show f is equal to open, and that is the file name, like C drive. So like it downloads and files, And next, that is a whatever, wherever your directive is, sir, wherever present your file, that should be giving. No, so this is the file name, sorry, path of the full path to specify. So we can use like this, if file is not present in the current working directory. So if it is present in different directory, we have to specify the full path of the file. So this is the example. So now I will read only the part of the file. Like I want to read some of the lines only. I don't want a whole text. So by default, the read method returns the whole text, but I don't want to read the all the text. So I can only specify the how many character I want to return. So we have, for that, we need to pass the number, like in read mode. So in read parentheses, we have to pass the number. So how many numbers you want to read? See, now in this example, I am going to demonstrate how to read a specific text only. I don't want whole text. I want to read only specific text. So I will comment this as of now, this line. So I want only specifically some of the content, not all the content. So there is a read, and you can pass the number how many you want. I pass 5. So I will get only 5. So A is equal to 1, because in you can check here. So this is my first line. So it will giving you, it is giving us only 5 lines. So I will hello world. So this is my text. This is my text. And now I will run one more time. I will run. So I will get only 5 lines. That's, see, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Only I will get 5. So now if I make changes to 10, it will give only 10. See, this is the usage of reading the specific line contents. So or in an exact way, only 10 character that will takes, means we are able to read only 10 character. How many how much number you are passing here, that's many characters you are able to read here. So this is the example. Now I will going to demonstrate the next example. Next, one second. So in next example, so I will going to, now we saw the how to read the file and how to read only specific characters. Now I'll demonstrate read line. So read line is the method in Python. We have the read line, so it returns one line by using the read line method. So if I want only one line, so we have the method called read line method. So by using that one, we can display or read only one line. So now I'll going to demonstrate how to use only one line. So I will comment this code and I will take, I'll copy this one and I'll revisit. Yeah, here only. So now next method I'm going to demonstrate you, read line method. So how to use read line method. Next I'm printing f dot, we have functions called read line. So you can see here read lines. So read lines means it will read all, only if you are using read line means it reads only one line. So now I will going to run this program, read line. So you can notice here, see, I got only one line. If I use read lines here, so it will give me entire text up in only one line. That is, see, you can see here, these things all I got in only one line. So this is the example for using read line. And by calling read line two times, you can read the two first lines. That is, if I want again, if I'm using here, I'll comment this line. So if I want to read two lines of the first line, so I have to call again and again same method. That is, f dot read line. So print f dot read line. So we can get to know that the first two line of the code will be executed. See, this is the first line and this is the second line. So by using read line, only one line of the code will be displayed. So this is an example. Like next, we can use the for loop also in Python. Like if I want to read the all the file line line of the file by each line by line. So for that we have a for loop. So we can use a for loop for even opening the file also. Now I will going to demonstrate how to use the for loop with the file. So as of now, I will comment this code. Now I will going to explain you how to use a for loop in Python for opening the file. So f open and mention the file name, that is notes.txt. So which mode you want to read? That is, I want in read mode. Next, I want to take one for loop for I in file, that is f. So colon and I want to print I. So now you can notice here all the file content text that will be displayed. So this is the usage of for loop in file opening. Now we have saw the now already we saw the opening. So reading in the different modes and using the for loop and easy reading the line by line. Now I'll explain how to close the files. It's a good practice to close the all the files. When we are working with the file, we have to close. So we for that we have the close method. And we should always close your file. In some cases, if due to buffering changes made to the file, may not be until close the files. For that reason, like if anything stuck in the file or any buffering in the file or any changes made to the file, that may not be closed properly. For that purpose, we have to close file by manually. That is by through script only. So for that we have the file name called file close method. So I'll close the file here. So f dot close, this is the method to close the file. See, this is the method. So now we have understood how to open, how to close, and how to perform the operations in file by using it. Is now whatever a concept I explained, that all comes under read mode only. Next I'm going to write mode up. So in this write mode, so we want to write the file to the existing file. So for that we can perform in two ways, like one is the append and one is the write. So if existing file is there, so we have to open that file first and we can perform the operations. Now I will show you how to use the append mode here. Now I will use the append mode and I will write something to the file and I will close that files. So now I will show an example. Okay, now I will comment as of now this code. So I want this code. I'll take this file and I'll open in append mode. That is, for append mode, as I explained already, we have a is a keyword. So here append mode. So I'll write something to the file. That is, how to write means we have functions called write. So f dot, that is file dot write. Write is the functions here. So now I will writing. I am writing to file. I'm writing to file hello. Hello world. So these contents I am appending to the file, that is the file name notes.txt, and I am closing the file f.close. So now I will run the program so you can see that there is no, nothing is happened because I not appended the content, but I am not reading the file. So here the operation I performed is write operation. So I performed write operation, but I am not able to retrieve. For that we have to open the file in read mode. So next I will read the file. So how to do that one means I have to take f is equal to here open is the function and specify the file name, that is notes.txt. Which mode you want to read mode, that is I am reading this file. So sorry, I'm reading the file and I'm printing the file. Print f dot, there is a function called read. So if I take read, it will give me all the content of the file. So now we can notice I appended this line. So this line should be appended in the file. Sorry, one second. Sorry, I'm giving file name is wrong. File name is a notes.txt. So I use double x. Notes. Okay, now we can observe if I change the file name should be here. Change. So I'll run the file. See. So see the last time updated this contents. So I am writing to the file hello world. I am writing to the hello world. Why? Because three times. One second. Okay, so yeah, because why it's happening, because means it's already I run one time this program, so it appended multiple times. Now so now what will I do is I'll append the new one with along with I will display here only. So now we will get to this is newly appended line. Newly appended line, thank you. See now, so I will append as well as I will read at a time. So now I will get to know only one time, that is this is the newly appended file. See you can notice here only one time I got this is duly appended line, thank you. So why these three times we got means, so I have already run two times this program. Before reading only, before reading I appended two times, that's why it's in file two times. So you can notice here in my file, see the yeah, you can see I am writing file to the hello three times, that's why it's giving me three times. Okay, now I have understood this one. Now I will going to how to write the content. Now we have studied how to read the content and how to append the content. Now in now next example I will explain you how to write the file. Okay, that is happened done, right? Now I will demonstrate like how to use the write method in the Python. So usually we use the w, that is write method, to override the entire file contents. So it will be like if you have the something in the existing file, if you have the already contents, that will be overridden by the append method, that is write method. By using that one we can override the file content. Now I will show the one example. If so, you see, in this file, like what happens if file is not present also, it will create the files. No, I will show you one example. So I will comment now. I will comment this code. And I will use a different. So I will take the f is equal to, and this is the open, and I'll mention the file name. So if I'll mention different file name, that is which is not present in the our case demo.txt. So this is file not present in my directory, or is it not present? So I will using the write mode, that is overwrite. So it will create the file, and I'll write the content to the file, that is f.write. You have to use f.write and write the whatever content you want. Hello friends, I am creating file and writing content. File. Okay. Now I have to close the file f.close. Now I have to open the file after the operation. I have to, after the overwriting, I have to open the file in read mode. So we have f is equal to open, and we have to specify the file name, that is here demo.txt. Now I will create the file. Okay, so I will automatically create by this using this command. Then I will open the file. See, now file has been created. See, you can notice here. See, hello friends, I am creating file and writing content. This is my I created file by using write operations, that is called overwriting. So now I will read this file. How to read? We have command called read. So f is equal to open and file name dot demo dot text, that is by default is a read mode, and I am reading the file, that is the next f dot read. So I'll print this file, print f dot read. So now we can notice here I'm printing the my file content. So we have to use comma here. See, this is my file contents. Now I will overwrite. So in my demo.txt there is a content called hello friends, creating file and overwriting content to the file. So now I will overwrite this files. How to overwrite means I will run once again with the different content, and I will read the same file. So hello friends, I am new to the file content. So this line I am writing. So earlier, see, can in this example, this is the already file contents. Hello friends, I am creating file and writing content is the my file content. So now I am writing, I am appending that one new content. So when I remove or run this program, so the old one will be removed. So you can see here, see, that content is gone and new content has been saved. This is the this is called a write operations in Python. So now we saw the write operations, and now we saw the read operations, and now we have to create a new file. So that is, we have functions called x, that is to create a file. It will create file and returns an error if the file exists. See, if the file already exists, it will give the error. So as I explained, append, it will create file and the specified file is not exist. See, if the file is not exist, it will create, it will won't give any error. Whereas in x, it will create the file and returns the error if the file is already exist. So this is the difference between two modes. Next, write already explained. So now I will going to demonstrate with x, that is create mode. So how to create the file? So we can create by using w mode also, and we can create using x mode also. So now I will comment this code. So f is equal to open, and I'll give some file name here with x, that is example, okay, example dot text. The mode I have to specify here, that is x, and now I will run the program. So it will create a file. See, you can see here the example file is created, that is example.txt. And so if file, it returns error if the file exists. See, now we have the file called example and demo and hello notes.txt. So I will try to create file which is already exist. So if file is exist, it should give error. If file doesn't exist, it should create the new file. So this is the intention of this create mode. So now here I will take already demo file is there. So now I will give the error name as demo. So it should give me error. Demo.txt. Now I will run the program. So you can notice here. See, file exists. Demo already exists. File already is there. That's why it's not creating. So this is the usage of x mode in the Python file. And next operations we are going to perform, delete operation. So how to delete the file? So in Python, to delete the file, we have to import the os module and run the os.remove function. So for that, I have to import the os module. Now I will show you how to work with deleting file with the help of import os. So how to import the os module? Now I will comment this code. So see, the best Python program practice is like we have to import the all the modules in the above the code, but right now I will import here only, import os. Now os.remove, there is a command called remove. So by using os.remove, and you have to specify the which file you want to remove. That is, so I want to remove, so I will remove, so I will remove which one, okay, example, nothing is there, empty file is there. So I will remove example.txt. So here I have to specify the file name, that is example.txt. Now I'll run the program. You can see that there will be file has been deleted. See, you can see you are not able to see here also, and from the here also I opened earlier, so that file also get closed because I deleted the file. And next operation I can show you the, like if how to check if file exists or not to avoid getting an error. So we might want to check the like if the file exists before you try to delete or not. So before deleting only, see, if the file exists, then only you can delete. If file doesn't exist, it will give obviously error. So now I'll run. So now I have deleted this example.py file. So now if I try to run again, it will give error because that file is not exist. See, system cannot find the file specified example.txt because it's already deleted. So now I'll check whether that example.file is exist or not. So for that I'm using the exist method here. So we along with the along with the OS module, we have to use like a os.path.exist and file name. If file is exist, then we have to use the os.remove to remove or delete the file. Now I'll show how to use that one. See, I'm using the import os. Now I will use the if statement with the help of os.path.exist method. So os.path.exist, see, you can exist and type the file name, that is example.txt. See, example it not showing only because it's not present, so already I deleted example dot text and example dot text, and if it is file present, I will removing the, sorry, I have to use if statement here. Okay, if at the end we have to give the colon. So if this file is present, I have to remove. How to remove? As I earlier showed, this is the statement. So here os.remove, then mention the file name we want to remove. So this is for checking the file. This is, I'm checking this file is exist or not. And if this file is exist, I want to remove this file only. So I'll remove this file. So I have to give the comma here, quotation mark, sorry, not comma. And if not present, it should give the alert message to the user, means it should execute else box, print file is not exist. So this is the file is not exist. Now I'll run, so I'll get to know file is not exist because this file is already deleted. So now I will show one example and like whether it is file is deleted or not. Now I will remove the demo.txt file. So I'll specify here demo and so now I will run this program. See, now the demo file is deleted. So the true condition, this statement is executed because that file was present. So this is a usage how to check the if file exist and then delete the file. Now we can delete the entire folder also by using command called os.remove directory. So we can remove the directory also. Now I'll not remove, just I'll show for your reference how to remove the entire directory itself. The command is os.rm. rmdir, right? Mention the directory name, that is like in my case this is the directory where it is. Yeah, so Django project is my directory. I can mention here Django project. If I run this program, my entire project directory will be deleted, so I'm not going to run this program. Okay, this is a usage how to delete entire program only. I hope you have understood this concept. Thank you for watching.